Hello, I'm back with another video. And I'm just standing in a forest at the moment, not really doing anything. But what I wanted to do with this video is to show you the world and what we've created so far. It's myself and a few other people from YouTube that have been playing on this on my server, some good friends, and I want to show you exactly what we've created. And this is it, a nice little hut. I'm only joking, okay. Bit of a lame joke, but there we go. So this is the main spawn point when you first join up, or when you first join. Load up into the server, and you know, you don't have any items, you're completely new to it, etc. But I basically set this up because in that direction there is a village, and that's where we decided to it's sidetracked there by a tree that's floating, but that's where we decided to set up you know, kind of where we want to live. This is just a basic hut with some kind of stuff to get you going, because during the night times you will be attacked by those green little fellas down there, and the camp is this way. So instead of walking through the trees, I'm just gonna fly over there. And we have a kind of a river that flows, well, it used to flow pretty much through this area. It does seem to be being blocked off in a couple of places, but it flows around a few chunks there not loading. And basically, I'll just give it a second to load. Okay. So basically, this is going to be a pain, right? But it's basically where we set up our village. And it didn't used to look like this. There was quite a few, you know, changes that have been made. This is one of our, you know, players' houses or home. It's you know, a castle with a courtyard type thing. And this is another one. It's quite weird looking, but you know, it does the job, I guess. And this is the main village area. So the reason why there's loads of cactuses down, that the mobs will actually get hurt by them, so you know, it's a good deterrent, and they hit them and cause some damage to them and even kill themselves, so that's good. And this is one of the buildings that I made, and it's just a simple kind of little church, you know, just a small, you know, doesn't hold that many people, but it looks great from the outside. And it's also got a downstairs area with a sort of library type thing going on, or you know, book storage. But you can also go up into the bell tower. Because one of the things I'm looking forward to with the next update is maybe being able to create a actual bell with maybe half blocks or something. So that'll be you know, a good thing. But yeah, this never used to be here. It was obviously just a plain area, And over this way used to be Jay Blackhawk's house, but he gave it up, and I built that one over there, and he decided to take it. So what I created in its place is an ice ring. You know, just a basic building, which I sadly had to rebuild part of it later, earlier today, I should say. And this is the inside. So some seating areas, some floating torches, and the ice ring itself. It's just, you know, for looks and decoration. Doesn't really do anything, but I think it looks okay. And some street lamps. I did go with these standard sort of black pieces of wall with torches on, but you know, a little bit of an upgrade and gone with glowstone glowstone boxes or cubes or whatever. This house belongs to Trouble. Well, so does that and that going all the way up there, which I'll show you a little later. This was a standard kind of village house like that one, but I've, you know, since modified it and made it a little nicer with an open fire. And I was going to leave it with the wood sort of walls, but I couldn't because the fire was setting fire to it. So, and this house has got a little melon garden, which you can't actually get out of, but can be changed later. Now, one of the cool features I've added is a chimney with actual smoke coming out of it. Looks quite cool. A bit of a wheat garden. This is just a standard village house. Our town kind of well. And this is now, well, it was just another level, so home, but she has since moved. So I'm not sure if you've seen it in any of the other videos, but it was a kind of tall building by itself with this attached to it. It has now since separated it and turned this into the village jail, and this is now just a kind of like garden type, you know, area type with a nether portal sat on the top of it. But let's have a look in the jail. And it's basically just a kind of sheriff's desk with a seat, a couple of seats. It's a bit fancy really for a, you know, a jail really, but it's basically leads down to two jail cells with working doors to keep the prisoners inside. I got a fancy bed, which is kind of a bit much really, but I do have an idea for another set of like type of bed, but yeah, you know, I'll do that at a later date. And that's about it. This used to be a mine, but I've closed it off. It's like if I punch through that wall, then I'll go into a mine, which seems to go under the entire village, created by one of the players on the. That joins up on here. If I jump up on here, you'll see that we've got a little bit of a garden growing and a water supply. A kind of river that flows down into two equal pools at the bottom. This is quite a cool feature. It's like a glass kind of cage with water in it. And you know the portal used to kind of expand off the roof of the house, but I've now changed it so that all you have to do is go this way. It leads you to this sort of balcony area, and then up to another portal with a lava pit either side, flowing lava. Yeah, it looks quite good from when we designed it, and I've just unattached it from the main building, that's all. And that's how it looks so far. So moving on, this is kind of my home with two standard, well, there's four little village huts which aren't used by anyone, but yeah, doesn't really matter really. All the villagers have since been killed or have moved on, so yeah. And this is my house. I've had to make it out of nether brick just because of a certain player likes to destroy things, so hence no door. Only I can pretty much get in here. And my bedroom with the sort of Donkey Kong style picture on the wall. And this leads up to the tower. Takes a little bit to climb up, but there we go at the top. Yeah, we've got quite a bit going on over there, and the village has changed quite a bit since first situated. Up on the hill over there is another player's house. So it's not finished yet though, so I won't show you that yet. And got a little wheat growing going on, and we've got quite a bit of wheat growing in certain places, and a little fire pit there by the beach area, if you can call it a beach. But we have a kind of river flowing all the way through this village to a bridge over there, so I'm just going to jump off the top and I'll show you the inside. Yes, I've had to resort to covering up my chest so that no one can steal stuff from it, but it's just a standard looking sort of kitchen area, seating area. That's about it. So I'll fix the door so that no one can go in there. This is just a standard little village hut. Nobody's gonna do anything with them, so they just sit there. And next, you've probably already seen this. If you got me on Facebook, then you'll know about the pirate ship, because I put a picture up on there. Well, a few pictures. But yeah. The big statue in the middle right there is a creeper, obviously. Used mossy cobblestone, which instead of using like green wall, which was a bit too kind of bright and trying to do the actual pattern and all that sort of would have been too much, and it would have been way too big, so I decided to kind of make him that sort of size. He's not equal or square onto the lower platform, but it's the best I can do really. And he's double sided, so whichever way you go, he's always looking at you.